Sometimes you do this before you have sex.
Paying for drinks?
No, no. Yeah. Hey allemaal, dit is Egbert. Welkom bij mijn kanaal. Vandaag heb ik uitgenodigd Jay, Matt en Danny. Zij zijn mijn vrienden uit Amerika en vandaag gaan zij Nederlandse woorden oplezen en ze gaan proberen te raden wat het betekent. Are you guys excited?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Of course.
So I have a couple of words and we will start with this word.
Feestje. Feestje. Feestje.
What do you think?
Fisting. That's fisting.
Fisting?
No, not fisting. It's fist. Yeah.
Fisting. So what do you guys think what it means?
It sounds like a party. Something fun. Something that you would enjoy doing.
Oh, like festive?
Maybe.
Wow.
It could be a party. Feestje.
Something festive.
That's exactly what it means. So the next word, I'll throw this word away.
That word is definitely natuurlijk. Yeah. It's pronounced eek. I don't know. All these words sound like drunk German to me. I don't know.
Natuurlijk. Natuurlijk.
So actually Jay pronounced it best.
What?
Really? Yeah. I told you it was eek.
I pronounce it natuurlijk.
Natuurlijk.
Yes. So what do you guys think what it is?
It's definitely a brand of shampoo.
I think cosmetics. I said
like,
that.
Like Tresemme or...
I think it's a food. It's something that you might eat. Or like
no.
Steak.
No. It's hiking.
Ooh. It means of course.
Oh!
Mm. Oh.
Next word.
That word is definitely shotzi.
Shotzi. Shotzi. Shotzi.
It's not French.
Shotzi. In Dutch we use a lot of g. Like if there's a C and an H, we also pronounce it like g.
Skeetje.
Skeetje.
It's kind of like challah.
Skatje.
Skatje.
I've had some good skatje before.
So what do you think what it means? What
I think it's mean? A drag queen term when you're mean to each other. Because it looks a little like shade.
So it means sweetheart, honey.
Yeah.
And you pronounce it like schatje.
Do you call?
It's a terrible thing to call someone that you like.
Yeah,
man, skatje.
Okay, next word. This is a difficult one.
That's easy.
Goedemorgen.
Goedemorgen. Like, these wooden shoes are so tight.
Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen.
That's really good.
Goedemorgen.
That's really good.
Goedemorgen.
See, now you're all gonna do like Swedish jam.
How do you pronounce it?
Goedemorgen.
Ah, oh. Goedemorgen. Oh, okay.
And it means good morning.
Oh.
It's close to the German.
Do you know German?
No, I don't know German. But not all Americans only speak one language.
Okay, you speak French, we get
yeah, it helps.
Next word.
I'm thinking maybe like the G could also be like an H.
No, a G cannot be an H.
What's wrong with you?
Gezellig.
Gezellig. Gezellig. Gezellig. I'm trying to do that like phlegm thing in the back of my Gezellig.
That sounds stupid.
Gezellig.
That's amazing.
There's definitely got to be some back of the throat action going
on. This is really good. So,
what is it actually pronounced?
Gezellig.
Because you knew it was an H. Who said it was an H?
You said it was not an H.
I didn't say it was an H.
Someone said it was like G is like an H.
But it's not.
Only to us.
I think it's an animal.
I was thinking a zebra.
It's definitely an animal.
Or something you eat off of. A table?
No. You eat off the table.
It means... Actually, there is no definition in the US.
Is there a translation?
What is
no,
it?
There is no translation.
So this word does not exist
can
in
you give us some general
it means
context?
It means cozy. And like everybody uses it in the Netherlands.
Cozy.
It's cozy.
But I think like, you just found a translation.
No, it's not. No, that's not a translation.
But it's
because
not.
Gezellig, it's like, oh, that's gezellig. It's like, it's not cozy. Do you think this is cozy?
No.
I think it's gezellig, so... Next one.
Drinking?
Drinking.
Drinking.
Drink.
Oh, that's definitely drinking.
Yeah, that's getting drunk.
Okay, done.
Is that exactly what it sounds like?
Yep, and it's also...
How do you pronounce it?
How you pronounce
drinking.
It? Drinking.
We don't have so many differences in our cultures, you know?
I know. So next word.
Knuffel.
Knuffel. I keep forgetting to do it with the accent. Knuffel.
Knuffel.
Yeah, that does sound like it should be right.
What do you think?
Knuffel? Knuffel?
Yeah. That's like, yeah, that was like
knuffel.
Exactly.
Knuffel.
Knuffel. Knuffel. What do you think it means?
Sounds like a sniffle, like you're sick.
You have a nipple? Knuffle.
It's a fight. A knuffle.
It's like a fight?
Yeah.
That's interesting. It's the opposite.
Oh, I was going to say it's like a washing machine. So, peace.
Okay.
Ooh, almost. No, it's not peace. I mean...
Well, yeah, it's gonna fight is...
Probably, if you do this to somebody, there's a lot of peace between you guys.
Sex?
It's sex.
And sometimes you do this before you have sex.
For play?
But is it paying for drinks?
No. I mean, you
how
can...
How do you do it?
It's like in a lot of different situations you can use it. It's a knuffel. I mean, if you're sad, you can give somebody a knuffel. If you're like happy, you can give somebody a knuffel. If you guys can pronounce this sentence for me.
Von je dit in looking video, abonneer dan op mijn kanaal.
Von je dit in look video, abonneer dan op mijn kanaal.
Knuffel. All
right. Clearly, that says, Vond, ye, dit en luken video, abonneer, dan op mijn kanaal. That's clearly what that says.
So what does it mean?
Thank you,
if you
for
like
watching
this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe.
Vond je dit een leuke video, abonneer dan op mijn kanaal. Heel erg bedankt. En je kan hier beneden kun je op de abonneerknop drukken. Did you like this video? Subscribe to my channel.
And comment below.
And comment below.
Und commenten durden down.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks.